Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, which is your station where you get to watch and learn. I'm your tutor, Mr. Mwangi, taking you through physics form 3. So let's stay tuned and do follow the lesson through. So what are the goals of this lesson? In this lesson we are going to look at equations of linear motion, and specifically we are going to refer to free fall and vertical projection. So by the end of this lesson, we'll be able to determine equations of linear motion with reference to free fall and vertical projection. So what is a free fall? At this point, all bodies near the surface of the earth experience a force of attraction towards the center of the earth, what we refer to as force of gravity. So free fall can only occur in a vacuum, since there is no air resistance. But if air resistance is ignored, all bodies fall with a constant velocity. So what does this mean? This means that a stone and a feather released at the same height will reach the ground at the same time, since they are falling at the same velocity. So equations of free fall, therefore, since they are accelerating towards the ground or towards the earth, and the acceleration is due to gravity, so in our equations of linear motion, we substitute A, which is acceleration, with G. That is, our first equation becomes V is equals to U plus GT instead of AT. In our equation 2, UT plus a half AT squared, the A in this case will help us to remember that the acceleration is due to gravity, and therefore we substitute A with G. In equation 3, V squared is equals to U squared plus 2AS, but since this is free fall, we substitute it with G, and it gives us V squared is equals to U squared plus 2GS. Now, motion graphs under free fall. You realize that they fall at a given point, and the displacement of the body changes with time, and it gives us a curve whose displacement increases with time. What about vertical projection? When the body is projected upwards, that is, it goes uniformly, retarding due to gravity, so it slows down due to deceleration and comes to rest before starting to fall with increasing velocity. So remember, the body, as it moves upwards, it is being attracted towards the surface of the earth by the force of gravity. So acceleration is negative due to the attraction of the earth's gravitational strength. So the equation, the sign in our equations of linear motion becomes negative. Therefore we have U minus GT, that is V is equals to U minus GT, S equals to UT minus a half GT squared. In this case, A, we substitute it with G, and our equation, the third equation, is V squared equals to U squared minus 2GS. So did we get to understand how we can apply this equation? Let's try to attempt the following retro quiz. So a stone is released from the top of the cliff 180 meters high. Calculate. So you will understand now that this is free fall. Yes. Question number 2, the time it takes to hit the ground. And number 3, the velocity with which it hits the ground. So you can refer this to secondary physics students book 3, or you can give us a text through the numbers on your screen, or visit our YouTube channel at Elimu TV, or Facebook page Elimu TV, or give us a tweet through the Elimu TV underscore tweet handle. So you can stay tuned to this and more lessons to come. And once again, I'm your tutor, Mr. Mwangi.